Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss about Giardia lamblia. It is worldwide distribution and the most common parasitic diseases. Habitat, it is present in duodenum and upper part of the jejunum in the small intestine. One host enough to complete their life cycle. Infective form, mature cyst. Mode of transmission, male get infection by ingestion of food and water contaminated with mature cyst and rarely by sexual route. There are two morphological forms we can observe, trophozoid and the cyst. Trophozoid motility, we can see falling leaf-like motility in the saline smear. Size is about 10 to 20 micrometer in length and 5 to 15 micrometer in width. Shape, in front view, it's look like pear shape or teardrop shape. Anterior part is rounded, posterior part is pointed. You can see picture 1. Lateral view, it's look like sickle shape, picture 2. Trophozoid is bilaterally symmetrical, that means when you cut the trophozoid laterally, you can see two same pieces. When we consider one piece, it contains one pair of nuclei, pair of median body, four pair of basal bodies, four pairs of flagella, pair of parabasal bodies, pair of exostyle. Cyst. The shape is oval in shape. Size is about 11 to 14 micrometer in length and 7 to 10 micrometer in width. It contains four nuclei and remnant of exostyle, basal body, and parabasal bodies. It is the infective form as well as the diagnostic form of the parasite. Pathogenicity mechanism. Trophozoid adhere to the duodenal mucosa and cause disruption of the intestinal epithelial brush border that lead to increased permeability and malabsorption. Malabsorption we can divide into various types: malabsorption of fat, disaccharide deficiencies, malabsorption of vitamin B12 and folic acid, protein loss, enteropathy. Clinical features we can divide into three stages. One is asymptomatic carriers. They are carrying the infective form, that means cyst, and the other group spreading the infection. Second one, acute giardiasis. Here we can see diarrhea with fat and mucus in infected patients, but no blood in the stool sample. Third one, chronic giardiasis, it may present with or without acute symptoms. Laboratory diagnosis, stool examination. Here we can detect the cyst and the trophozoid stages by using wet mount, saline and iodine concentration technique. Entero test, antigen detection in stool by using ELISA and ICT. Antibody detection in serum by using ELISA and IFA. Culture technique, molecular method by using PCR. Radiological finding by using X-ray. Treatment, metronidazole, tinidazole, furosolidone are the drugs we are given to the infected patients. Prevention: improved food and the personal hygiene, boiling or filtering of potentially contaminated water, treatment of asymptomatic carrier, health education. No vaccine is currently available. Subscribe our channel, click the bell button. Thank you for watching.